Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna have a look at the Nike Air Max 2090, which we have here in two colors. The first one is supposed to be called full black, but you also have some gray and silver around the top part. So the 2090 is the latest shoe in the Nike's Air Max line, and it's related to the late Air Max 90, which was released in 1990. But the new Air Max 2090, it's a new series. Which now it's a performance shoe, but also a lifestyle shoe. If you want something really low key, there are all whites, like you can see there in the background, with a bit of orange. And you can also get them in other colors. You have few options available out there. So, starting with the upper side, it's mostly covered by translucent mesh. The mesh is pretty lightweight and somewhat see-through if you have the white ones and you have a colored sock, you can see it through. The textile liner goes right up against your feet and generally feels okay, but doesn't really have as much stretch as the Nike Flyknit. But towards the toe box area, there's an additional layer of protection around here, which is not the same color. As you can see, it's slightly darker, but it's gonna prevent your toenail from poking through the mesh. And it's also slightly glossy to be distinguished, which, to be honest, I don't actually like, but that's just my opinion. The lacing and the eyelets are in a loop style mechanism where the black flat laces intervene through them, like you can see them here. Underneath the laces, there's a black mesh tongue, which has a strange rubberized ring here inside a diagonal cutout, and the lowercase air logo, which are cut off halfway, as you can see it here. This is a very weird design element, but to be honest, I kind of like it because you can help yourself when putting the shoe on your feet. Coming to the inside of the shoe, there's a black sock liner, this one here. And you'll notice it's a one-piece internal booty construction, but I like it. The insoles are the usual Air Max insoles, which are in black and with 2090 printed on top. I don't know if you can see it. Towards the heel, and the Nike swoosh inside, this is full black. Moving on the top mid panel, there's a black Nike swoosh outline that is embedded within the outer layer. Like the Air Max 90, the swoosh here is slightly cut off at the bottom, which is accented with this gray stitching. As you can see it here more clearly, it's yellow. On the black, you cannot see it so clearly. You also have here the black stitching on the mudguard, which is another element borrowed from the original Air Max 90. But this is gonna be all full black. The back of the shoe has a ton of padding on the heel. The foam padding definitely adds to the comfort of this shoe, but it's also rigid enough to give support to the back of your heel and help with a secure heel lock. On the outside of the heel area, there's another mesh-like finish, this time in black, covered with a rubberized heel tab bumper with grooves, which is another element related to the Air Max 90. Above you have this black pull tab robe loop, which is the same color as most of this black type shoe. Coming to the midsole, it's pretty chunky with a black colored foam on the forefoot and a thick air unit towards the heel. Here it feels like the React foam, but if you look on their website, it's not mentioned anywhere, so that's just me. The air window on the back, it's like almost 200% bigger than the standard air unit used before on the Air Max 90, and it's housed within the black color TPU shell. Coming to the outsole, it's made of a black gray rubber with grooves on the forefoot that are similar to the waffle outsole on the Air Max 90. Towards the very top of the toe area, there's another hint of gray with grooves on the forefoot that are similar to the waffle outsole on the Air Max 90. And this groove pattern is meant to give you a better flexibility with the shoe, and they seem to allow just that, to be honest. So let's have a look also at the white version, which they are the same beautiful shoe, and you cannot just have one pair. You'll also need to have at least one black, one white. I also wanted to take the green Volt, but I thought that it's a bit too much. But look at it. Look at them. They are so nice. So, guys, if you liked this video, don't forget to press like and subscribe. And I will see you in my next videos. Thank you for watching.